Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to you. Welcome to the sponsors, the prize givers, teachers, families and friends of the contestants and lovers of good music. I'm Damien Beaumont and I'm absolutely delighted to be here in the beautiful Verbrugghen Hall as your compere tonight for the 2014 IFAC Australian Singing Competitions Finals Concert. And I'd like to start by acknowledging the Gadigal peoples of the Eora Nation, original owners of this land, and we pay our respects to their elders past and present. Now, we want you to be able to relax and have fun tonight, so with that in mind, would you just like to check again to make sure you've put down all of your favourite eye devices and just be present in the moment with us, please. So if you could, please also leave your camera in the bag. As you saw by the red carpet tonight, we have plenty of photography covered. And also, if you would just take the opportunity to double check that your mobile phone has been put on mute. Thank you. Tonight, our finalists have the exciting opportunity to sing with the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra, conducted by Maestro Johannes Fritzsch, giving the evening a great start with Berlioz's overture to Beatrice and Benedict. And although the focus will be on young singers for the rest of the evening, I know we will all appreciate the contribution of these experienced musicians in making it one to remember. And I'm sure that many of you also enjoyed Maestro Fritzsch's illuminating talk before the concert. It is through the generosity of Dr. Haruhisa Handa, who is well known to Australian opera goers, through his continuing support of Handa Opera on Sydney Harbour and the International Foundation for Arts and Culture, that the singers may enjoy the privilege of performing with the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra. Unfortunately, Dr. Handa was unable to be here himself tonight, but we welcome from Japan Ms. Midori Miyazaki, Director of International Affairs and Managing Director of Dr. Handa's Business Operations in Australia, Michael Gasson. And would you please pass on our grateful thanks to Dr. Handa for his support over an extraordinary 17 years. And we would also like to welcome our special guest, Mr. David Coleman, MP, Member for Banks, representing the Minister for the Arts, George Brandis, QC. Thank you for joining us this evening, Mr. Coleman. This year, we had 80 entrants from Australia and New Zealand who participated in rigorous heats around the country. And for the very first time, expat Australian and New Zealand singers were given the opportunity to be heard in London. From these heats, 11 talented young singers progressed through to our semi-finals at the Concourse Theatre in Chatswood. And tonight's finalists have also had the exciting opportunity of working with and being mentored by national adjudicator Jeffrey Black in a public masterclass with respected accompanist and vocal coach David Harper. And you will soon be able to enjoy segments of the singing competition's YouTube channel, which to date has had more than 400,000 views. The adjudicators this year have given generously of their time, bringing to the job the wisdom of experience as they carefully assess the needs as well as the talents of the contestants. And you can review their impressive credentials on the competition's website. The finals program is also available online with all of the details you could possibly want. Now, I'll quickly introduce the adjudication panel, and I'd like just to ask you to hold your applause until the end of all of the introductions. Jeffrey Black is an internationally renowned baritone and also a winner of the Marianne Marty Scholarship. Jeffrey deserves special praise for his undertaking so capably the role of national adjudicator. Jeffrey has had an impressive international career, but he might well count this among his more difficult roles. Jeffrey approached it with the same dedication and consummate professionalism he has given to singing and has been universally praised for the manner in which he has worked with his fellow adjudicators and for his sensitive approach to the sometimes, as you can imagine, nervous young singers. Joining Jeffrey tonight, Conal, an internationally acclaimed bass whose career includes opera and concert engagements with all of the major Australasian and many overseas companies. And you can still catch him tomorrow in the final Sydney performance of The Elixir of Love with Opera Australia. Michael Halliwell is a celebrated baritone who tonight represents the Sydney Conservatorium of Music, where he is Associate Professor of Vocal Studies and Opera and the Associate Dean of Research. Emma Matthews, last year's National Adjudicator and a highly acclaimed and awarded coloratura soprano, who just this week finished a successful run of Rigoletto with Opera Australia. And Benjamin Schwartz, a renowned cellist and director of artistic planning with the Sydney Symphony, and since 2011 he has also collaborated with Seiji Ozawa as artistic administrator of the Saito Kinan Festival Matsumoto in the Japanese Alps. Please welcome with warm applause Jeffrey Black, Conal Coad, Michael Halliwell, Emma Matthews and Benjamin Schwartz. And I would also like to acknowledge three previous National Adjudicators who are in the audience tonight: Anson Austin, Sherilyn Camorley, and Glenn Winslade. Our competition is renowned for its caring and supportive ethos, and this is demonstrated in the continued support from our past adjudicators. And you, the audience, also have a challenging task: choosing the winner of the most audience prize, presented by Music and Opera Singers Trust Limited. Now, you would have received a voting form on entry into the hall. Please complete the voting once you've heard all of the singers. And I'll explain the voting procedure later in the program, because it really is high time that we let the singers take the stage. And so to start, we have 24-year-old soprano Kate Amos. Many of the singers you'll hear tonight are high achievers across many disciplines, and Kate is no exception. She has trained in classical ballet, pursued acting, and was a competitive swimmer. But her first love is singing. She has an honours degree in music performance from Melbourne University and is doing a Masters of Opera in Performance in conjunction with Victoria Opera, where she is a developing young artist. And she has also earned a diploma in Italian, which should serve her very well, as tonight she sings Piangerò, La Sorte Mia, I Will Bemoan My Fate, from Handel's Julius Caesar. Now, to set the scene, Cleopatra's brother Ptolemeo has ordered her to prison for scheming with the now apparently drowned Caesar. Saddened by the turn of events, Cleopatra contemplates her fate and how, when she is dead, she will come back and haunt her brother. It sort of sounds like a plot from Game of Thrones, doesn't it? But I assume with less nudity. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Kate Amos to sing Handel's Piangerò, La Sorte Mia.
Hey, poor cause.
Thank you, Kate. A wonderful opening for tonight's singing. Our next singer, ladies and gentlemen, is Isabella Moore, a 23-year-old soprano from Auckland, New Zealand. Isabella recently completed, with distinction, a master's degree in advanced vocal studies at the Wales International Academy of Voice. Isabella studied singing almost by chance. After high school, she intended to enrol in a fine arts course, but missed the application deadline. Her teachers and family encouraged her to pursue music instead, which I think was a wise decision. Tonight, Isabella will sing Come Scoglio, or Like a Rock, from Così fan tutte by Mozart. Come Scoglio is sung by the fiercely devoted Fiordiligi. Well, at this point of the opera, she's devoted. Fiordiligi has had enough of the two Albanians, who are really her fiancé, Guglielmo, and her sister's fiancé in disguise. She proclaims her love for Guglielmo and asks the Albanians to abandon any hope that she or her sister will ever be unfaithful. Famous last words. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Isabella Moore to sing Come Scoglio by Mozart.
Come.
Thank you, Isabella, for that stirring rendition of Come Scoglio by Mozart. Samantha Clark is a 23-year-old soprano from Perth. Samantha is currently completing a postgraduate diploma in classical voice, opera studies at the West Australian Academy of the Performing Arts. Samantha confesses to a secret ambition to try her hand at stand-up comedy, but sadly we won't be treated to her comedy stylings tonight. Instead, Samantha will perform Porgi Amor from Mozart's Le Nozze di Figaro, The Marriage of Figaro. This is the Countess's lovely and moving aria in which she laments the loss of her husband's affection. The Countess's principal emotion throughout much of the opera, and particularly in this aria, is a melancholy longing for the man her husband was, or who she thought he was. Here she prays to the God of love to restore him to her. Please welcome to the stage Samantha Clark with Porgi Amor. Thank you, Samantha, for that moving rendition of Porgi Amor. Anna Voshege is a 24-year-old soprano from Melbourne. She holds a Bachelor of Music degree from the Melbourne Conservatorium of Music and will move to Austria later this year to undertake a Master's of Singing at the Vienna Conservatorium. Anna is such a passionate performer that she's been known to sing orders to customers at the cafe where she works in Melbourne. But sadly, she won't be bringing us our lattes before performing O zittre nicht, mein lieber Sohn, tremble not, my dear son, from Die Zauberflöte. The Magic Flute was one of Mozart's last works. He died barely 2 months after its premiere. In this beautiful aria, the Queen of the Night tells the handsome Prince Tamino of her daughter's kidnapping and recruits him to rescue her. She promises him that her daughter will be his wife if he can achieve this task. Please welcome Anna Voshege to sing Mozart's O zittre nicht, mein lieber Sohn.
Oh!
And thank you, Anna, for that wonderful performance of O Zittre nicht, mein lieber Sohn. Our final performer, but not our final performance, is Corinne Cowling. Corinne is a 24-year-old soprano from Perth. Corinne is studying for a graduate diploma in voice at the West Australian Academy of Performing Arts, where she obtained her Bachelor of Music in Classical Voice. Last year, Corinne was awarded the inaugural Dame Mary Gilmore Award for the most promising overall final year female student at WAPA. Corinne is not only an accomplished singer, but also a teacher of dance, an enthusiastic traveller, and a devotee of Shakespeare. Corinne's first piece for this evening is Eccomi in lieta vesta, o quante volte, from I Capoletti e I Montecchi by Bellini. Behind the libretto for Bellini's opera stand many Italian Renaissance sources rather than Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, though the story is immediately familiar. The scene is set on Giulietta's balcony in the palace of the Capulets. Giulietta is longing for Romeo to come and see her. She wishes to see his silhouette in the light of the day and hear his sigh, which reminds her of the breeze. Please welcome Corinne Cowling to sing O Quante Volte by Bellini.
Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you, Corinne. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you'll see that the errant circuit breaker has been replaced. There was some beautiful timing of some light. I mean, as radiant as they are, it's lovely to see. Now, earlier this evening, I mentioned the Most Audience Prize. It's not only a singer who wins this evening. If, when voting, you also subscribe to the mailing list, you'll be in the draw to win a beautiful watercolour called The View from Observatory Hill from Sydney artist Tanya H. You will also, of course, always be the first to hear the latest news from the Australian singing competition, so subscribe today. Nothing to lose, really. Now, this seems an opportune time to tell you a little about the history of the competition. The Australian Singing Competition was established by solicitor Roland Gridiger to realise the vision of his client, dedicated singing teacher Marianne Marty Frisdane. And over the many years, many luminaries of the music fraternity have given their expert advice on how to structure the competition and have also helped with the development and acquisition of valuable scholarships. It is through the support of many people this year that we are offering over $190,000 worth of prizes and opportunities. The Australian Singing Competition enriches the quality of music in Australia. The competition has been operating for over 30 years and is administered by Music and Opera Singers Trust Limited. Over 200 singers have participated in the competition and have had the benefit of being heard and interviewed by eminent professionals from the classical singing fraternity. Of the winners of the primary prizes, the majority are pursuing careers in Australia and overseas, as are many of the singers who have shared well over $3 million worth of prizes or valuable opportunities. And I'm thrilled to say that one of those winners is with us in the audience tonight, Aisa Gertner-Chanal, winner of the Marty in 1998, the inaugural year of Dr. Hander's generous sponsorship. And none of this would be possible without the support of our amazing sponsors and prize givers, many of whom are in the audience tonight. But sadly, there are far too many to name individually. But if you visit the website, you can view the complete program with the sponsors' details. Follow the W's. aussing.org.au, aussing.org.au. And thank you to you all for your belief in the importance of the competition. Now, let's get back to the music. For her final item tonight, Kate Amos will sing Quel guardo il cavaliere, so anch'io la virtù magica, Norina's aria from Act One of the opera Don Pasquale by Donizetti. This is the first time we meet the heroine, Norina, and we find her reading a book about love. And after reading a passage aloud, she exclaims its hilarity because she believes she already knows everything about tricking men and making them fall in love. Ladies and gentlemen, to sing Quel guardo il cavaliere, so anch'io la virtù magica by Donizetti, Kate Amos. Thank you, Kate, for that cheeky performance. Next, we'll hear Samantha Clark's second piece, Depuis le jour, from Louise by Charpentier. Depuis le jour is one of the most popular arias from the opera. Louise is a young girl still under the thumb of her parents until she falls in love and realizes her true destiny. This aria occurs in the third act after Louise has run away with Julien, whom she loves. Louise sings of her happiness with her new existence and reminisces about her first day of love. Ladies and gentlemen, Depuis le jour, to be sung by Samantha Clark.
Sweet.
Thank you, Samantha. A truly charming performance. Our next performance is of the aria Ernani, Ernani, Involami. It's from Verdi's Ernani, which will be sung by Isabella Moore. This is Elvira's Act One cavatina. Elvira hates the old Count da Silva, whom she is to marry. She longs for her lover Ernani, the commander of the bandits, to come and take her away from the old man's embrace. Elvira explains that no amount of riches or jewels can buy her love, and that she would rather live in a cave than go without Ernani's love. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Isabella Moore to sing Ernani, Ernani, Involami.
Thank you.
Thank you, Isabella, for that delightful presentation of Verdi's Ernani, Ernani, Involami. Next, Corinne Cowling will be singing Heimliche Erforderung, one of a set of four songs composed by Richard Strauss in 1894. Strauss gave it as a wedding present to his wife, the soprano Pauline de Anna. The text is by John Henry Mackay and describes a couple, secretly in love, who are trapped in the midst of a party of drunken revelers, and the couple long for the moment they can finally be alone. Please welcome Corinne Cowling to the stage to sing Heimliche Erforderung.
Wenn du sie hörst, so winke mir heim.
Thank you, Corinne, for that wonderful performance. To finish this evening's competition pieces, soprano Anna Voshege will present Glitter and Be Gay from Candide by Leonard Bernstein. The original production of Candide is the stuff of legend, mixed reviews, and a 73 performance failure. A comic adaptation of Voltaire's satire, the operetta has had an incredible afterlife with two Broadway revivals and countless mountings in opera companies worldwide. The aria, Glitter and Be Gay, for leading lady Cunegonde, is doubtless the most famous piece from the operetta. Cunegonde has become a courtesan and she is bemoaning her lost purity, largely because she feels that she ought to do so, and is trying to convince herself that her glee and delight in jewellery is a sign of character when faced with adversity, rather than a sign that she has always liked pretty, shiny things. To present Glitter and Be Gay, please welcome back to the stage Anna Voshege.
Lovely, can they dry my tears? Can they blind my eyes to shame? Can the brightest rose shield me from reproach? Can the purest diamond purify my name? And yet, of course, ye trinkets are endearing. I boast and glad my sapphire is a star. I rather like a 20-carat earring. If I were pure to lace my jewels are.
Oh, thank you, Anna. What a magnificent way to end the competition. Always nice to have a bit of glitter. Now, while you're relaxing at interval, the adjudicators will be working very hard to decide who will win what. So perhaps now, as they depart to tackle this task, it's a good time to give a warm thanks and a round of applause to Conal Coad, Michael Halliwell, Emma Matthews, Benjamin Schwartz, and the national adjudicator, Jeffrey Black. And ladies and gentlemen, we should also thank Maestro Johannes Fritzsch and the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra for so ably supporting the finalists. Speaking of interval, it's now upon us, and you are invited to partake in refreshments, which can be purchased in the foyer, and return in 20 minutes for the conclusion of the program and the announcement of the winners of all of the prizes, and especially the 2014 Marianne Marty Scholarship winner. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the second half of our evening, and thanks to the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra and Maestro Johannes Fritzsch for that performance of the suite from Der Rosenkavalier by Strauss. Haven't we truly been treated to a wonderful evening of fine music? And indeed, I think that every second clap was for Strauss himself. Who could imagine writing such extraordinary music? Maestro Johannes Fritzsch and the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra has given the singers the best kind of preparation, guiding them so ably through the rehearsals, as well as this, the crucial final performance. It's a privilege for these young singers to work with experienced professionals and a pleasure for us to hear them sing with an orchestra. So a sincere thanks to you, Maestro, and to the orchestra. So ladies and gentlemen, please give another rousing applause for Johannes Fritzsch and the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra. There was a presentation for you back there. It's gone to the vultures now. I should also mention that Leppington Valley Farm has kindly donated all of the gift baskets that have been presented this evening. Roey's Cakes also generously organised a little surprise for you all. But you'll have to wait until the end of this evening to find out what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you a little about Music and Opera Singers Trust Limited, MOST for short, which administers the Australian singing competition. MOST doesn't just help singers, it also administers the Pascal Foundation, which presents the annual Pascal Prize for the Critic of the Year. The most recent winner was Melbourne critic James Lee, and the Rona Tranby Award, which enables the recording of Aboriginal oral histories of their elders. And many of you may already know that there is also another singing competition administered by MOST, which is conducted in private, and the Opera Awards offers a substantial amount of money and some wonderful opportunities to assist professional opera singers with further studies for career advancement. And this year, the Opera Awards will be staged in November in Melbourne, and for further details on the newsletter and on the website. Now, it's with great pleasure that I now call upon Mr. David Coleman, MP, to say a few words on behalf of Mr. George Brandis, the Minister for the Arts.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Damien, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And it's terrific to be here representing the Minister for the Arts, Senator Brandis. It's been a great privilege to be in the audience this evening, and I'm sure you'd agree with that, and to hear the remarkable music and some of the extraordinary voices that we've heard. And one of the conclusions that I've reached is that regardless of the outcome of the contest this evening, that clearly Kate, Isabella, Samantha, Anna and Corinne have a very, very bright future ahead of them, and it's been great to hear from them tonight. Nights like tonight are a great reminder of the importance of the arts in our society, and it says something very good about our society that we're all here tonight to celebrate the talents of these exceptional people. So I'd like to congratulate everyone who's been involved in organising this great event, and certainly wish all of the finalists all the very best for their future careers. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Coleman. Through the International Foundation for the Arts and Culture, Dr. Haruhisa Handa supports many causes around the world and has given financial assistance to this competition over a number of years. He has asked his good friend and vocal coach, Conal Coad, to speak tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Conal Coad.
Well, what a wonderful night. All sopranos, my favourite. Mind you, I have to say, if they'd told me it was going to be all basses, I think I probably would have sent in a doctor's certificate. So tonight I've had two very pleasant duties to perform. The first, of course, has been to join my fellow judges in choosing the winners tonight, and you'll be hearing about that in a just a very few more minutes. Secondly, I'm joining Miss Midori Miyazaki here in representing my good friend Dr. Haruhisa Handa. Dr. Handa has long been a sponsor and friend to the Australian singing competitions and indeed to music throughout Australia. I think 3 years ago when he joined up with Opera Australia to present the Handa Opera on Sydney Harbour, everyone was hoping it was going to be a big success, but I don't think anyone had a clue just how big a success it ended up becoming. And it's a great delight to know that following those first three productions, he has signed up to do another three. And next year, hopefully, you will all be there at AIDA. And I want you to choose your night very carefully because I'm singing in one of them. apart from opera in Sydney, Dr. Handa also, with Opera Australia, this year brought a new venture to the Gold Coast, and that was Opera on the Beach. And it was a huge success, three nights singing for, something like 10,000 people, which was quite marvelous. I believe it's coming back with another opera the year after next, but so we look forward very much to that, particularly since that's the neck of the woods in which I happen to be living. He also is a great sponsor and supporter for young talent generally. Next year, he becomes the principal financial sponsor for the New Zealand Singing School, which will become the Handa New Zealand, IFAC Handa New Zealand Singing School. Now, if I could ask you all for this incredibly generous and wonderful supporter of the arts to join me in a round of applause. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Conal. A few of our spaces will have a word to you afterwards. It's wonderful to know that there are such organisations as IFAC and benefactors like Dr. Handa providing financial help for the sort of talent we've been privileged to witness tonight. Dr. Handa has also asked his Director of International Affairs, Miss Midori Miyazaki, to speak on his behalf tonight, and I now welcome her to the microphone.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so very much for your support tonight once again. Dr. Handa, unfortunately, is not here, as you know, but I am sure that he will be extremely proud of the performance and the talent of all the singers who have done so well tonight, and we are all blown away. And I know that you want to give them a big round of applause for their wonderful performance once again. And I also have to say that, you know, we salute their parents and their teachers and all the people who have supported them to become such wonderful talents. As some of you may have heard, Dr. Handa is a great lover of Australia. He does not hesitate to call your country his second home. And so I will obviously take this message back, and obviously he will be very, very encouraged to support you, hopefully next year again. But in the meantime, I also want to say thank you to Roland Gridiger and his wonderful team for always pulling together a first-class event for all of us and for the young singers. And to all of the adjudicators who have tirelessly supported this event, and also to my lovely and dear friend, Conal Coad. He is a very, very genuine person, but I must say that the success that he basically contributed to in the concert that we recently had in Japan with Renee Fleming, Dr. Handa himself, was amazing. It was a free of charge concert for all of the people in Tokyo who cannot afford a ticket for to go to an opera at that caliber. So I would like to thank Conal for his contribution and for his generosity in helping us in that way. Uh, But before I go on for too long, just as a closing remark, Dr. Honda will not like me to leave this podium without saying his favorite Australian word, which is bloody good night to all of you. So thank you so much. And I hope you had a good night, and we look forward to the awarding ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you, Midori Miyazaki. As this will be broadcast on ABC Classic FM, I think our editors might be having to press that bleep button. Let's hope not. It's time to get excited, ladies and gentlemen, because Jeffrey Black is waiting in the wings with the results of the adjudicators' deliberations. Please welcome to the microphone Mr. Jeffrey Black.
I will keep this very brief because we've already had a number of speeches. But firstly, might I, as this is to be the first opportunity, could we all join in thanking what a magnificent job that Damien Beaumont has done for us this evening. As Damien mentioned earlier, we have, throughout this competition, listened to just a little under 100 singers throughout Australia, and also singers coming from New Zealand. And for the first time, expats who have already made the journey across to the UK and London, UK and Europe, and the heats took place in London. And we hope that this will be the first of many such occasions, because for those aspiring young artists who have already begun the journey, it takes an enormous amount of courage to do that first step, and it would be a shame for them not to be able to have access to the funds that a competition such as this provides. I would also like to offer my vote of thanks to the judges here tonight, of course, but also it would be remiss of me not to thank the judges who helped in my deliberations throughout Australia. And I would like to, if you will allow me, would you also thank them for both for their efforts tonight and also for all of the judges throughout Australia during the heats of this competition. Now, as you're undoubtedly aware, the deliberations for this particular competition are perhaps unique in Australia, given that it is a competition which has a lower age limit than others, and is a competition which is very much judged on potential. Now, potential is a difficult one to gauge. Does one find a diamond in the rough and imagine what that talent is going to be like in a few years' time with the proper coaching and the proper encouragement? Or does one look at the finished product? In this particular instance, you are more likely to be looking at the former for this particular competition. Without betraying any confidences, I can certainly tell you that the discussions, in inverted commas, in the judges' room have been quite robust this evening. And that's as it should be, because all of the artists have performed very well this evening. And some of them, I would say, show already that they've made great leaps and bounds and are, for their particular voice type, are ready to begin launching themselves into roles professionally. And in fact, some of the discussions I've had with a number of the artists when I was speaking to them as the national adjudicator, I had encouraged them to, without being irresponsible, but particular for those artists of particular repertoire, they should be looking to find smaller houses, moving over to Europe, to find out those roles that are going to suit them best. For others, the gestation period is much longer. Now, without prolonging the moment any further, please let me bring Damien back to the microphone and we can get on with the business end of proceedings.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Why don't you stay right here, and we're sharing one microphone, so you have to squat.
Okay.
The five finalists are each awarded the Zoe James Prize, a posture and voice controlled body review, and the Opera Australia Prize, an opportunity for all finalists to attend rehearsals in Melbourne or Sydney, observing an opera throughout the stages of its production. Let's please call the finalists on stage for the announcement of the individual awards. We have singers Kate Amos, Samantha Clark, Isabella Moore, Corinne Cowling, and Anna Voshege. Congratulations to all of our performers for giving such a splendid finals concert tonight. Now, Geoffrey, if you're ready, our first prize, the Universal Music Australia Prize, a collection of classical CDs presented by Universal Music Australia to
Corinne Cowley.
We have a lot of prizes to get through. I just want to say the next award, the Christine Leaves Award, 30 hours of publicist consultation, business planning and promotional exposure over a one-year period is awarded to
Samantha Clark.
The David Harper Award, 10 lessons with David Harper either in Australia or the United Kingdom, won by
Isabella Moore.
And the Whopper International Arts Song Festival Prize, a scholarship to attend and participate in the 2015 Whopper International Arts Song Festival, including flights, accommodation, and masterclasses with internationally renowned accompanist Graham Johnson. This exciting new prize has been won by
Corinne Cowling.
The Symphony Australia Young Vocalist Award. Cash and a professional engagement with an orchestra in the Symphony Australia network has been won by
Kate Amos.
The Bel Canto Voice Program Scholarship, an opportunity to attend the Audition Training Opera Program held by Bel Canto Summer Voice Program in Munich in 2015.
Anna Voshege.
The Nellie Apt Scholarship, airfares, living expenses and fees for the Israel Vocal Arts Institute program in Tel Aviv in July 2015 is awarded to
Samantha Clark.
The Miranda Scholarship, a grant to study Italian in Italy, which is awarded to
Kate Amos.
The Royal Overseas League Music Bursary, a cash grant from the Victorian branch of the League and return flight to the UK with 2 weeks accommodation and hospitality in central London at the Royal Overseas League's Private Members Club Overseas House. Rosal Arts will arrange several performance opportunities in London or Edinburgh, and the winner is
Kate Amos.
The Mozart Opera Institute Award provides fees for 1 year's study at the Mozart Opera Institute of the Mozarteum University in Salzburg in the post-diploma opera course for the academic year 2015-16. The winner will also receive $3,000 Neil Paschal Award, and the winner is
Anna Voshege.
And there has been glowing reports from previous winners of the Leverhulme Royal Northern College of Music Scholarship, and they can be viewed at the ASC website, and also glowing reports from the College on our Australian singers. The winner this year will also receive the $3,000 Phoebe Patrick Award, and this scholarship goes to
Samantha Clark.
The Guildhall School of Music and Drama Award is a scholarship for 1 year's study at the college. The winner will also receive the $5,000 Clark and Associates Prize. These are all awarded to
Corinne Cowley.
And now, dear friends, it's your turn. The most audience prize is a cash prize of $500 selected by audience vote. Presented by Music and Opera Singers Trust Limited, Most. And you have selected
Isabella Moore.
And the member of the audience who has won the beautiful watercolour painting whose name has been drawn out of a hat by a secret cabal of name pullers is
Françoise McCallum.
A wave. Your painting will be posted to you next week. Finally, just before this year's winner is announced, a big congratulations to Roland Gridiger, Chief Executive Officer, together with the Most team, for keeping this competition going all of this time. An amazing 33 years in all. Congratulations. In addition to the Marianne Marty Scholarship of $30,000 to assist with vocal study or career advancement, the winner will receive audition prize from Lyric Opera of Chicago's Ryan Opera Center, an opportunity to audition for Lyric Opera of Chicago's Professional Artist Development Program, the Patrick G. and Shirley W. Ryan Opera Center, a professionally produced resume by Editorial Resources, Lightbox Photographic Award, portfolio of publicity photographs, Fine Music 102.5 recording engagement, a studio recording with Fine Music 102.5 to be broadcast on the Australian Fine Music Network, the Faye Franco Prize, web design and content consultation through the provision of a website as a service, the Lily Usher Prize portrait, a painting of the winner in concert dress, a studio broadcast engagement for national transmission on ABC Classic FM. Also, an interview by oral historian Dinah Rich, which will be recorded and retained within the oral history collection of the National Library of Australia. And this beautiful limited edition sculpture by Drago Cherina. If a monetary value were to be put on all of these prizes, the winner's takings would be well in excess of $50,000. But the worth of opportunities arising from such a win far exceeds that figure. It is with pleasure that I, announce Jeffrey Black will now announce the winner.
It's unfortunate he can't read a script. It is indeed my great pleasure to announce that the 2014 Marion Marty Scholarship has been won by Isabella Moore.
Congratulations, Isabella. Take a deep breath, because it's your turn at the microphone now. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to introduce, speaking for the first time as the 2014 Marty Awards winner, Isabella Moore.
I always like to say I'm a public singer, not a public speaker, so bear with me. I'm so grateful and happy to have won the Marty Award. It's been an amazing opportunity, and I know winning this award will help me on my path to becoming an opera singer. I couldn't have gotten this far without the help of some important people. First and foremost, my parents, Sina and John, who are sitting up there. my family and friends and my support crew who came tonight, some who have come all the way from New Zealand and from around Australia. So thank you. I'd like to acknowledge my singing teachers, Dennis O'Neill and Nucha, who are based in Wales. I couldn't have gotten this far without their guidance and knowledge. to my fellow competitors, you're an amazing bunch of girls, and I've loved getting to know all of you. a massive thank you to the adjudicators. It's been a privilege singing for you throughout the competition and especially tonight. Also, without the amazing orchestra behind me and their amazing leader, Maestro Johannes Fritzsch, tonight wouldn't have been possible. I loved working with you all. And thank you to Dr. Handa. Without you, we wouldn't even get to sing with this fantastic orchestra. And to all the sponsors, you give young singers like us a real shot at the big time, and I really appreciate it. And last but not least, thank you to the IFAC Australian Singing Competition. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, and home ground support, home team support, we've almost come to the end of the IFAC Australian Singing Competition finals concert, but you can hear it all again on ABC Classic FM on Tuesday the 9th of September at 9:30. Now, we bid farewell with our thanks to Geoffrey Black and this evening's magnificent performers, and thank you to our singers, to Johannes Fritzsch, and the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra for such a great night's entertainment. The adjudicators and organisers for all of their hard work. And ladies and gentlemen of the audience, I thank you for your enthusiastic response and continued support of the Australian Singing Competition. Thank you to the Sydney Conservatorium of Music for having us, and good evening to you all. Would you please once again thank not only the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra, but our finalists. Thank you very much. Good evening.